Hello everyone.
Then we are three questions of sound chapter. Based on the formula we have studied already. So we have studied formula. T is equal to 1 upon F. F is equal to 1 upon time period. And V is equal to mu into lambda.
We have studied this formula till now in sound chapter.
Now based on these three formula, we have three questions.
Any more questions are there?
But over here, first question is find frequency of a wave whose time period is 0.02 second. So solution of question number 1. What is given? Time period is given 0.002 second. So we have to find frequency. So frequency is equal to 1 upon time period, that is 1 upon 0.002 hertz. When we remove the decimal and solve it, we will get 500 hertz. So very easy to solve this one. Just for practice, we have started the easiest one. Now, solution of question number 2. Find time period of a wave whose frequency is 400 hertz. So, what is given? Frequency is given 400 hertz. And we have to find time period. So, time period is equal to 1 upon frequency. So, 1 by 400. One upon 400 second. After dividing it, we will get its answer 0.0025 second. Okay. So by this way, we solve these two questions. Third question we have: a source of sound produces 20 crest and 20 trough in 0.2 second. One crest and one trough together forms one wave. So in 20 crest and 20 trough together we'll make 20 wave. So we have given question number 3: 20 crest plus 20 trough is equal to 20 wave in 0.2 second. Time is given 0.2 second. So time is given 0.2 second. So 20 waves are produced in 0.2 second. So what we can write in 0.2 second? Number of wave 20. So in 1 second, number of wave will become 20 by 0.2. That is, decimal will remove, 0 will come over here. So 100 waves will be produced. So, and number of waves in 1 second is called time frequency. So, frequency will become 100 hertz. Number of waves in 1 second, frequency. Find frequency of wave. So, we got frequency of wave, I think you would have understood, in 0.2 second. Number of waves 20. So, by unitary method we got in 0.2 second number of wave 20. So in 1 second number of wave will become 100. That is the frequency of the wave. Now children, see this question. The wave velocity of a wave of wavelength 2 cm in water is 16 meter per second. Wavelength is 2 cm and wave velocity is 16 meter per second. What we have to find, calculate the number of waves produced in 1 second, and number of waves produced in 1 second is called what?
frequency. So we have to find frequency and time required to produce one wave. It means we have to find frequency and time period both. So let's solve. Wavelength lambda is given 2 cm. It means 2 by 100 meter. And wave is given 16 meter per second. So from this formula we can calculate frequency easily. So first we will find frequency by formula V is equal to F into lambda. So F is equal to V by lambda. V is 16 by lambda, 2 by 100, 16 upon 100 will go up and 2, 18, 8. So frequency is how much? 800 hertz. And 800 hertz. Now we got frequency, answer of question number 1 A. Now B, answer of B is what? Time period. So we can calculate time period by 1 upon frequency. So 1 upon 800 second. After dividing 1 by 800, we will get 0.001 0.00125 seconds. This much time will be taken to produce one wave. So we calculated this one. So we have to understand the language of the question, and by using simple formula we can calculate. Now let's see next one. The sound wave has frequency of 2 kilohertz. Question number 5. Sound wave has frequency F is 2 kilohertz, means 2000 hertz. And wavelength lambda 35 centimeter, 35 by 100 meter. How long will it take to travel 1.5 kilometer? So we have to find what, how long it will take to travel 1.5 kilometer. So if we find speed of wave, then we can find time, because distance is given. So first let's find V. So V is equal to frequency into wavelength, 35 by 100, 0, 0 cancel. 700 meter per second. Now V is 700 meter per second. And distance is given how much? 1.5 kilometer. It means 1500 kilometer. So 1500 meter it is. Now we are knowing V and S. It means velocity and speed we are knowing. Then we can calculate time. Speed we are knowing. Distance is given. So we have to find time. Time is equal to distance by speed. So 1500 divided by speed. 700, 0, 0 cancel, 2.1 second. So we done this one. I think you would have understood, because we are using the same formula again and again. Only we need to understand the language of the question. Now, when we have this sixth question,
we have been given a graph for a wave. The amplitude versus distance graph, amplitude and distance are given in centimeter. So what we are saying here, that from the question, the frequency of wave is 50 hertz. We have been the frequency of wave 50 hertz. 50 hertz is the frequency of wave, and we have to find wavelength, amplitude, and wave velocity. We have to find all these. So now let's see how we will find. Then wavelength. Already the distance between two consecutive crest or two consecutive track, this will be equal to the wavelength of wave. So over here, as the graph is plotted between distance and amplitude, so from graph we can find distance and amplitude also. So here the distance between two crest and two trough, here this one is the distance between two crest and two trough. So 15 minus 5, that is the wavelength. So wavelength lambda of wave is 15 minus 5, 10 centimeter. Now let us see amplitude. Over here we have written 4 and it is 2. So maximum displacement of molecules of medium from mean position to one of the extreme position is 4. So that is 4 centimeter. B, amplitude is 4 centimeter. Now we have to find wave velocity. So for third one, we have to find, and we know that V is equal to frequency into lambda. Frequency is given 50 hertz here. Frequency is given. So 50 into lambda 10. So 500. What will be the unit? Centimeter per second. Centimeter per second. So by this way, this kind of question also we can solve easily, but we need to pay attention, we need to understand the question. So keep on solving the questions like this, then you will have very good grip on numericals also. So children, now they see the 7th question. An observer standing at the sea coast observes 50 waves reaching the coast per minute. If wavelength is 10 meter, find the wave velocity. Same kind of question is there. Same formula we had to use. So over here, what the observer is watching? 50 waves reaching the coast per minute. So in 60 second, number of waves, how much? 50. So in 1 second, number of wave reaching the coast, 50 by 60, 5 by 6 wave. So number of waves in 1 second ko, what we said? Frequency. So this one is the frequency, 5 by 6 hertz frequency. Now what we have to find? Wave velocity, and wavelength is given 10 meter. So wave velocity we have to find F into lambda. F 5 by 6 into 10, 50 by 6 meter per second. We will convert it into decimal. Now question number 8. Over here, how far does the sound travel in air when tuning fork of frequency 560 hertz makes 30 vibrations? Speed of sound in air is 336 meter per second. Then frequency is given 560 hertz. F is given 560 hertz. So time period 1/560. Second, so time period is 5/60 second. So this is what time taken to complete one wave. So what is that? In thirty vibration. Frequency in the that much 30 vibration. So 30 vibration in one vibration. Time taken is 1/560 second. In one vibration, time taken is 1/560 second. So in 30 vibration, time taken will be 1/560 into 30, 3/56 second. So what we have to find? Distance S and V is given. This is what? In 30 vibration, how much time will be taken? When the speed is 336 meter per second, then V is given 336 meter per second. And time is this one. Time is 5/56 second. So distance is equal to speed into time. 336 into 5/56 meter will be the answer of this question. So by this way, children, you have to apply your understanding. Only then different kind of questions will be solved. So questions are based on the formula same we have studied. So you can see in this question, there is a graph for a wave disturbance propagating in a medium. The graph is between displacement and time. What we have to do? The question is given. The find time period, frequency and wavelength of the disturbance if the wave is traveling with velocity 1500 meter per second. So over here what we see, the distance between two consecutive crest is how much? That is 3 minus 1 2 meter. First time period we have to find. Time period in 1 second. 1 second, what do we see? Number of wave produced is how much? Children, seeing the graph, we can find time taken to complete one is wave 3 minus 1. 2 second. 3 minus 1 2 second. So its time period will be 3 minus 1. Answer of question number 1, 3 second minus 1 second 2 second is the time period to complete. It's a time to complete one wave, that is 2 second. Frequency. From this graph, frequency, number of waves in 1 second. So over here what we see? 2 minus 1 1 second. In one second one wave is completed. No, half wave is completed. So frequency is equal to what? 1/2 hertz.
Yes. Then see, we have to find wavelength of the disturbance. Wave speed is. In this question, if the disturbance is traveling with velocity 1500 meter per second, the given graph represents displacement versus time graph. Displacement in time graph, displacement is given in meter, time in second. So we have to find time, period, frequency and wavelength of the disturbance traveling in the medium. So children, time period, so time taken to complete one wave will be completed between these two crest or these two trough. So 3 minus 1, 2 second. So time period is 2 second. Frequency in 2 second number of wave completed is 1. So in 1 second number of wave completed will be half. Now frequency is given, speed is given. We can calculate wavelength from this formula. Okay, so easy formulas are there again, I am telling.